everybody. I'm Rachel, Teen Services Manager at the Frankfort Community Public Library. And I wanted to tell you about a book that right before I made this video, I checked and it is currently available with no holds on Libby. I read this book a few years back and it was so good. It was a book that I never stopped thinking about in that, like, I feel like I could read it over and over again and see different things in it. It was just really unusual, and I'm not even sure what genre to call it, except for maybe coming of age, but it has so much into it that it's supernatural, it's artsy, it's sci-fi, it's got everything. And the best way I could describe it is, if you remember those Choose Your Own Adventure books, it kind of has like a Choose Your Own Adventure feel that is kind of cool, but that's not exactly what it is. It's very hard to describe, but it's so good. So I want to read to you real quick the Goodreads description. Oh, by the way, I don't have a picture of the book because I did read it on Libby, but by the magic of video, I will slip it in there and you'll be able to see the picture of the book. So, I want to read the Goodreads description of this book. And I'm just going to warn you, there's some French in here, and I'm not the best at pronouncing French words. I took a lot of French, but pronunciation in French was not my strong suit. But I did call my sister and get some help, so hopefully I sound all right when I pronounce it. All right, here's the description of Jane Unlimited. If you could change your story, would you? Jane has lived a mostly ordinary life, raised by her recently deceased Aunt Magnolia, whom she counted on to turn life into an adventure. Without Aunt Magnolia, Jane is directionless. Then an old acquaintance, the glamorous and capricious Kyrian Thrash, blows back into Jane's life and invites her to a gala at the Thrash's extravagant island mansion called Tout Revanche. Jane remembers her aunt telling her, if anyone ever invites you to Tout Revanche, promise me that you'll go. What Jane doesn't know is that at Tout Revanche, her story will change. The house will offer her five choices that could ultimately determine the course of her untethered life. But every choice comes with a price. She might fall in love. She might lose her life. She might come face to face with herself. At Tout Revanche, anything is possible. So, Tout Revanche, if I sound silly saying it over and over again, I think they just had to stick that French in there several times in the description. But what that means, if I'm understanding right, it means you go back. So, it's really cool. You go back. That's the name of this island, this like magical island. And I love the beginning description where it says, if you could change your story, would you? And how often does somebody think about their life and think, what if I could go back and change that one decision? What would my life have looked like if I had done this or that differently? And this story kind of explores that idea. And now I want to read you, this is before I started my Bookgram, but on my actual Instagram, I often would take pictures of books that I was like falling in love with, and I would post stuff about them. And here's a little tip. I will share this post that I had originally posted on my Instagram. I will share it on my Bookgram if you want to see it. And so you'll be able to find it at the YA Librarian on Instagram. And one thing I really love about reading books on Libby or Hoopla is to screenshot something that I find really interesting. And then I use the markup on my iPhone in edit, and I highlight and I underline things that are really cool in the book that I want to remember later. And then if for some reason I need to come back to that book, or I want to read that book again, or I need that idea for something else. I've got it saved in this space where I've drawn this picture on it and saved it on Instagram. So there's a little ebook tip for you as you're using ebooks and so forth right now during this time when the library is closed, but 24/7 virtual resources are available. But this is what I wrote on my Bookgram. This book is wildly good. First, it's about a mysterious mansion filled with class distinctions. Next, there's a suspicious art thief. There's suspicious art thieving. Then it's a spy novel, continuously changing. It's like a choose your own adventure with no choices. Mixed with the X-Files, mixed with the yellow wallpaper, with maybe like a Beatles soundtrack, with a little Doctor Who mixed in, and yet it is not disjointed. I don't know if it's a book with a plot or a book about books or a book about plots. Anyways, that's it. Hashtag Jane Unlimited. I really loved this book and I highly recommend it. And we are doing hashtag Diverse Reading 2020 right now. And I want to say that Jane Unlimited is definitely an option for hashtag Diverse Reading 2020. It would fit under the person with a unique coming of age story, because Jane's coming of age story is so cool. And I just love this book so much. I feel like I could talk about it for, there's so much about it that I could talk about for so long. There's a library in it that I still remember and think about sometimes. The way it was described is so interesting. And also I just want to like point out her name is Jane, and she has like all these different chances to create herself over and over again in this book. And I just kind of find that so interesting that the author chose to name her Jane, because Jane is often the name that's given to somebody that's not identified, the Jane Doe or so forth. And I just think it's just such an interesting journey reading this book about self-identification and about choices that you have in your life and about falling in love and loving your family. And it's just so many cool adventures in it. I highly recommend it. I could keep talking about it forever, but this video would go into like an hour or something long. So I hope that you read it. If you do, like or comment, tell me what you think. Follow me on Instagram at the YA Librarian, and I will be sure to put up the posts that I made back in the day when I read that book. And let us know what you thought of our video.